everybody, it's Carissa again, and we're doing the Bold and Easy Spring Scenes book, and we're gonna do this one today. We're gonna do this picture. I think it's pretty cute. I think we should use our watercolor brush pen markers. Now, when I say they're watercolor, I don't mean they're water-based. I mean they're the watercolor type markers, like this from Arteza. They have actual, like, brush tip on them, not like the felt kind. I like this kind of brush tip just fine. It's like a nylon brush tip sort of thing, with like actual bristles. So we'll do this picture today. I'm thinking, let's start with some actual soft colors. Start with this soft peachy color. I've got my magazine page back here protecting the underneath. So yesterday was Halloween, and I had my friend Noah over. If he's watching, hi. I'm crinkling this paper for you. For ASMR. But anyway, we had a lot of fun, and we saw a lot of costumes this year. Like I said, I talked about in previous videos, you can tell what movies are popular, especially horror movies, by what kids dress up as for Halloween. So this year, it was a lot of Beetlejuice. There was one kid, it was the Terrifier from that Terrifier clown movie that just came out. There were a lot of skeletons for some reason, a lot of skeletons. Yeah, so that was what was popular this year. It was definitely Beetlejuice. But I love trick or treat. I know, you know, you're probably like, well, you know, you're an adult. Why do you like trick or treat? Well, I grew up in the Ozarks. I'm from the Ozarks, for those of you who don't know. And I grew up in the country, and there was no trick or treating. Wasn't really a big thing. But when I grew up, I moved to a place where trick-or-treating is a big thing, and there's lots of people with their kids and neighbors who want to go out trick-or-treating, so I love the ability to, like, hand out candy and see all the costumes. Let's see. Is this the same type of flower? I don't know. I think this is a different type of flower. Whoops. Doesn't matter. Well then, wait, no, because it's coming off of here too. So I think it is the same type of flower, never mind. Got confused there. Color. centers. And I think I'm going to carry this pink color over to these roses. I do like these markers because I can really saturate the page, and streakiness isn't really a big issue like it is with others sometimes. I don't see any more of the... There's like these baby's breath ones, but I don't see any of the roses. Pardon me while I dig around in here. A little bit of this red. Not much. What color should we make the baby's breath? Let's go with kind of a soft yellow color, like this. By the way, I put numbers on all of these. At one point they were organized to a color chart, but I never use it, so whatever. That's all the baby's breath. Wait. There we go. So. You're gonna think I'm crazy, but I'm gonna come in with this soft aqua color. I'm gonna add a little bit to the baby's breath. Just give it some interest. Some color. I'm also gonna put a little bit in here. I like that, it stands out. Not a lot, just a little bit. In the middle there. There we go. Helps tie the blue and the aqua kinda helps tie it all together. Here. Let's see. I've got kind of a warm theme going, so let's do an actual yellow flower with some orange. Let's see. Let me look at the greens here. I think I want to start out with this one. Yeah, I think we'll start out with this one. Okay, these are the same plant. Good. I was worried they weren't. Just kind of shading with this green color. Realize how much this one particular branch took up. See, this was also that part of that. This is part of that. This part of it too. This is also part of it. I think that's all of it. Okay. Some of this baby's breath here. But thankfully I already have the yellow out for it. There we go. I'm gonna come in with a light yellow. And I'm gonna blend into this green. Stems too. Back with like a darker green and shade, I think. This goes to that, maybe. I don't know. We'll make this one the same color. Around here. Let's look at these leaves. Let's go in with, let's see. Whoops. I'm sorry, that was really loud. I just dropped some stuff. I apologize. wasn't too loud. I'm really embarrassed by that. I can't go back, though. Sorry. I hope nobody was, like, asleep and that scared him awake or something. Oh, gosh. Anyway. We're moving on. That's a lesson we all gotta learn. Moving on. Take out my red bin, and I'm going to show you what we're going to do that with that in a minute. So here's our red bin. Now let's look at this. Let's use orange and let's go back with green. We're kind of keeping the colors in the same theme today, I think. So I'm going to go with green on the outside. Postmaster. So where these lines are, I'm gonna overlap them. Just like that. Same here. There we go. Now for the envelope. I'm gonna bring back, remember that aqua color we used on the baby's breath? Flowers here. I'm going to bring that back. And we're going to use that for shading the envelope. Sorry, I've got to turn this. Marks are I just put just trying to add some volume to the envelope here. We turn this around. Just trying to like build up the bulk of it. Okay. I'm pretty happy with that, but you can see the background is very plain and I hate just leaving it like this. So, since I dropped my glitter markers, we can't use those. So, we're gonna use a different color. Magenta color, maybe. I think that might look nice. We're just gonna kinda come around. Instead of like scrubbing really hard, I'm just kind of dragging the brush tip just a little bit, barely touching it to the paper. Too concerned about being neat. I think it'll add to the style, kinda. Come back with another color also. Okay. Alright, so we got that. Now let's come back with our second color. We're gonna use this orangey yellow color. I think this is the same color as the baby's breath. Do know that purple and yellow shouldn't mix, but this is kind of a ready purple, so it should be fine. And we're just gonna kind of overlap and let them mix and do their own thing. So they go outside the lines, they overlap and interlock and go outside, just adds interest. At some points you can see yellow, some points you can see magenta. Some points you can see both of them. Let's see. sometimes just even doing simple little things like this, I feel like help. So I'm just touching into the paper and lifting off. Touching it and lifting off. And I hope you had fun today. Sorry about all the noise. But I hope you had a good time. And I hope you'll like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope you'll stick around. And I'll see you next time, okay? Bye-bye.